Dementia is described as being a progressive neurological disorder, and basically what that means is the brain cells are dying, and ultimately it will lead to death.
I can't recall.
So the person may start off by having issues with their memory, which may lead to issues with remembering events or days. Then it can progress on to not being able to perform tasks like driving the car, like preparing a cup of tea or preparing a meal. And more they're having to give up the things that they hold dear in their life.
Time.
To watch a person that you care for greatly, to see them change quite significantly over time is difficult for you to come to terms with, but more so for them to come to terms with the fact that they're no longer the person that they were. You can see them go through quite a bit of anguish over that. If only you could take that anguish away, but unfortunately you cannot.
1, 2, 3.
It's a very difficult disorder for people to cope with, and what we're trying to do with the Forest Project is engage with people that gives them back some control with something that they might enjoy in life.
And look at what happened.
The Forest Project is using virtual reality to engage people with dementia.
So the Forest Project is a virtual, interactive, immersive environment. And what that means is it's much like a traditional video game where you interact with a virtual environment through the use of various control interfaces, in our case, a gesture-based one.
And down, down, look at that.
So you know, you wave your hand and the wind blows, or you clap and the leaves fall.
They were interacting, and because of them, things are happening. They move the arm up, down, and something is changing. And they are very aware that it's because they did something in order for that to happen, to change. So it's a huge benefit.
So it was a meeting with the Opaque Multimedia Group, and we were talking about gaming technology, and I remember in that conversation he mentioned how game developers, for them it's very important to communicate to people how to play their game through the game itself. So you are educating people through the game, you're educating them how to use the game. And that really struck me, and I thought, wow, if we could get a game that you could use a minimum of words to teach people, that would be a very powerful tool.
The Forest Project itself, we started with a photorealistic forest, and afterwards we realised Australian forest is a bit boring, and we actually had to convert to a hyperreal forest. The forest would expand itself in terms of the software side to include more environments. So we currently have an idyllic forest, but the next one we have a lakeside and maybe a ski slope, perhaps even a underwater environment and things like that.
Look how beautiful it is.
It does.
Look how beautiful. How beautiful it is.
People living with dementia are not stimulated. They don't get enough recognition for their abilities. They have to have a purpose. So with all these programs and projects, what we do is we give them a reason to get up from bed every morning. That's basically what we do.
Look, here it is. There you are. Even flowers.
Dementia is a progressive illness, and the latter stages of the disease, it is very difficult at times to engage and communicate. So we have always taught people that what they need to do is to tap into people's senses. If you want to communicate and engage, you tap into their senses, and that's the way to do it. So the power of virtual environments is that they can give us a means by which we can tap into those senses.
One of the lady we had in our trial expressed it as it was magic, like she had magical powers.
Wow, things are happening.
My God. I've never had anything that's magic. I changed the weather.
You did change the weather.
And that was what really engaged. And that's the kind of stuff that you can't achieve on a static medium such as a film. And we must achieve it through interactivity.
It's wasting his time with the photograph.
Oh, because he likes your face. That's why he's taking a photo of you.
His eyes must be bad.
We saw it as a very interesting project, and we learned a bit more about dementia. We learned a little bit more about how severe it is. From then, I think we started thinking less of a, in terms of business arrangement, there's almost like a moral obligation to make sure these projects get done.
It is about the quality of life. You know, we are spending a lot of money on research to find a cure, of course, but that could be some time away. And I would like us to spend some money on quality of life for people.
Our job, basically, when we use all these innovative programs, is to have those minutes, because they are minutes of happiness. We give them a chain of happy moments. That's because it doesn't last. It doesn't matter how long it lasts, we do it for the moment. That's why we do it, it's for the moment. They are smiling and they are glowing.
Having seen some of the responses that people have made to the Forest Project, it's fantastic. It's heartwarming to see the people living with dementia become responsive, they become excited. And what we found is that even through sort of the fog of memory loss that's associated with dementia, they tend to remember their interactions with the forest.
It's Arthur, see?
Today it was wonderful watching Agnes, because we have worked with Agnes before, and people say that people with dementia don't have any memory, but clearly they do, because Agnes today showed us that she remembered.
Unbelievable, look at them, look at that. The flowers.
That's what I want, you know, for this project. I want people to have quality of life. And this is a way of giving them that.
Yes, I'm coming. It's time to go.
Time to go?
Yes, it's time to go.